So we'll move on to the topic called as gearing and re-gearing. Okay, company A is in supermarket business and wants to enter into construction business, but will not change the capital structure. So company A has two risks. One is business risk and the other one is financial risk. So company A wants to enter into the construction business. So we have to look also in the construction business. So construction business company B also has two kinds of risk. One is business risk and financial risk. Okay. To compute the discount factor for company A, supermarket company, for entering into construction business, we have to find the beta. We have to find the beta, but the beta has to be recomputed. Okay. We can't use the discount factor of A or company B. Why? We'll check in the next one. Why can't we use the discount factor of company A and company B also for valuing this new thing? See, what happens is we need to enter into the business risk of company B. Right? So this, we don't need the business risk of supermarket. That's like unnecessary. And we are going to use our own capital structure. So financial risk is going to remain the same. But for company B, we don't need financial risk, because financial risk of our company is what is required, but we need the business risk of that company. So we are going to use the financial capital structure of company A and the business risk of construction company. So what happens is we have to create a new beta, that is company A entering into construction business. So the financial risk of supermarket will fall down and the business risk of construction company has to come together. This will now create a new beta. So to work out this as a problem, we need ungearing and regearing. So these are the formulas for ungearing and regearing. Okay. So we'll work out this as a problem later. So you can just go through the formulas here. We'll understand like this. There's something called as a asset beta. It's called as asset beta. So this beta refers to the operational risk of the company alone. So we can say this as the business risk. Okay. Or simply we'll refer to as B alone. Equity beta. This refers to the financial and the operational risk of the company. So if you take this, it includes both business and finance risk. So we can put it like this. It includes the business risk and the finance risk. So the asset beta, okay, the asset beta is also called as ungeared beta, okay, and the equity beta is also called as geared beta. Okay, so just ensure that you understand, you memorize this concept. So asset beta is called as ungeared beta and equity beta is called as geared beta, and the asset beta refers to the business risk alone and the equity beta refers to the business and finance risk put together. Okay, so that's how the concept works. So we'll again start. So the first step is called as ungearing, the second step is called as regearing, and the third step is called as like finding out the KE. So this formula you had already seen in cost of capital. So KE equals to RF plus beta into RM minus RF. Okay, so the new steps that are in the sum are this ungearing and regearing. So that's how it works. We'll look at a problem and we'll see how this is going to be used. So we'll start from here. BCO is a hot air balloon manufacturer whose equity debt ratio is 5:2. The corporate debt, which is assumed to be risk-free, has a gross redemption yield of 11%. So RF in this problem is 11%. So that's why he says risk-free, gross redemption yield is 11%. So RF is 11%. The beta value of the company's equity is 1.1. The average return on the stock market is 16%. So the RM is 16%. The corporation tax is 30%. So we'll put like T is 30%. Okay. So that is the one part of the problem. The second is the company is considering a waterbed manufacturing project. YESCO is a waterbed manufacturing company. It has an equity beta of 1.59. Their equity debt ratio is 2:1. BCO maintains its existing capital structure after the implementation of the new project. What would be a suitable adjusted cost of equity to apply to the project? So we'll do like this. So assume that we are going to do a KE for BCO. The problem when you do a KE for this, RF plus beta RM minus RF. So the RF is 11%, RM is 16%, again this is 11%. Okay. So which beta should you use? The question is, if we use BCO's beta, okay, if we use BCO's beta, we have to have two risks. So one is business risk and the other one is finance risk. But if you use BCO is into hot air balloons, okay, but BCO wants to enter into waterbed manufacturing. So we cannot have the business risk is not what we want to enter. So what about this? The finance risk is correct because beta cos is not going to change its existing capital structure. So the finance risk is correct, but the business risk is wrong, okay, because what we want is not about the hot air balloon. We want to end the company wants to enter into the waterbed manufacturing. So the finance risk is right, but the business risk is not the appropriate one. If we take YESCO's beta, YES company's beta, YES company again has two risks. One is business and the other one is finance. But again, we have a problem. They are into the business that we want, but their capital structure is different. For example, BCO's capital structure is 5:2, but YESCO's capital structure is 2:1. So if the problem says that the capital structure of BCO is not going to change, in that terms, the business risk of YESCO we want, but we do not want the finance risk. So ideally, what we want? We want a new beta, okay, something called as a rear geared beta that takes the business risk of YESCO and finance risk of BCO put together. That is what we want here. So how do we do this? That is where the regearing problem comes in, the ungearing and regearing problem comes in. So these are the steps. So we'll start with step one. Step one is ungearing. So take the other company. So take the other company, YESCO, their beta, and we have to do something called as an ungearing. So the formula works like this. The geared equity beta or equity beta is equal to asset beta into the value of equity plus the value of debt into 1 into 1 minus tax rate divided by the value of equity. So this alone has to be computed separately and we have to do this. So look at how it works. This asset beta refers to the business risk and this multiplication here, and this refers to the capital structure. So and business plus finance risk equals to the asset beta plus this is the gearing part or the capital structure part. So what this formula does is it takes YESCO's equity beta, this number, okay, and it tries to find out and it removes this capital structure element, okay. So if it removes the capital structure element, what is left is, if this is removed, then what is left is the asset beta. What is asset beta? Asset beta refers to the business risk. So what is the business risk? The business risk here is the waterbed company, waterbed project. Okay, so that risk alone we can remove separately. So we'll do first the ungearing. So we have the formula here. So we have to get the equity beta of ESCO. So ESCO's equity beta is 1.59 equal to asset beta, that is a business risk that we don't know, we have to find out the value of equity. So the value of equity is like directly given in a proportion 2:1. So 2 is the value of equity and VD is that 1, this 1 into 1 minus T. T is 30%. So here is the 30%. So we'll minus the 0.3. This has to be first computed. So we'll work it out. This is 1.59 asset beta into 2 plus 0.7 in divided by 2. So that gives you 1.59 equal to beta asset into 1.35. So we'll have asset beta this side. So 1.59 divided by 1.35. So asset beta will be 1.17. So this is the asset beta. That is, this number refers to the water bed project, okay, beta. But still, this does not include the financial risk of BCO. So that we have to do it again. So we'll go to the next step. So step 2 is called as regearing. In regearing, we take B company's financial risk or financial structure, okay, and that we add it and get a equity beta. Okay, so that's what we want. So we'll again write the formula. Equity beta equals to asset beta into VE plus VD 1 minus P divided by VE. So now we will see the numbers. So we already got the asset beta from the earlier step. Earlier step showed us 1.17. We'll take that number 1.17 into VE. So which company's capital structure we have to take? We have to take the BCO's capital structure. So BCO's capital structure is 5:2. So 5 plus 2 into 1 minus 0.3 divided by again 5. So this has to be solved first. 0.17 into, so we'll solve the number. It's 5 plus 1.4. So we'll take the balance here. So 1.17 into 1.28, we'll get the equity beta. So we get 1.497. Okay, or we will take it as 1.5 as the beta. So what does this beta represent? This beta represents the business risk of ESCO, okay, and it represents the financial risk of BCO. Okay, so that's what this number represents. So our next step is to find out the KE. We'll do that also. So step 3, find KE. So KE equals to, we already know that RF was 11% plus the beta that we got is now is 1.5 into 16% minus 11%. So RM minus the RF. So we'll start now. So We'll solve the internal part. The internal part comes to 7.5. So also this is also can be like taken as percentage. So if we solve, we get 18.5. We get 18.5%. So that is the KE. That's about the problem here. It is a little lengthy problem. So if you keep doing the problem again and again, you will get a better understanding how it works. So once you have got the understanding, it's really quick to use. As an advice for you for the formula, the step take it as ungearing, then regearing, then the finding out the KE. But always try to use this formula itself for both the ungearing and the regearing. Okay.
You can reach me at my website wowacademics.com, or you can also see my Quora answers. I am active in LinkedIn and in Facebook page. So you can visit at these places. If you just type Shyam Prasad and Wow Academics, you will get all these links in Google search itself. And if you like this video, give a like, share to your friends. And if you feel that any points we have missed in this video, you can post it. We will try to give an answer to you in the comment section itself, or we'll also create another video for you. So thank you for watching our video.